Hello, the software gives me information that I'm live. As usual, I have my doubts that that's really the case. So I'm going to ask you again, like every week, to give me a short information if I'm really live. It's been reliable last couple of times, so I'm optimistic. Yeah, hello to the people in the Twitch channel. There's a question, can we challenge you today? Sure, why not? I mean, I usually play in the pool, but if you send a challenge to me, I will play the odd game. Yeah, let's go for a 5-minute game. Last week I tried with some somewhat wacky openings, and this time I'm going to play it like I usually do. Yeah, trying to score some points. Okay, I'm playing Dropstone here, an international master from Russia. We got the Grünfeld defense. Yeah, hello to Wroclaw Chess. I'm not sure how to pronounce it, yeah. And welcome, yeah, greetings to Switzerland. Yeah, they play that bishop e6 stuff now, and he probably will know his book moves. No. I mean, okay, I'm not saying that this isn't good. It's just that I never saw that move coming. So maybe bishop g5. B6. Interesting. Yeah, probably just go B4. Yeah, the video setup reminds me of Star Wars when they communicate by holograms. Yeah, like in Star Wars Episode 4, yeah, with those holograms popping out of the robots, yeah, a little bit like that. Okay, knight c6, I'm attacking that with b5 and he jumps to b4. An interesting position here. The knight on a2. Okay, I'm going to play c6. He has knight a2 as a possible idea. It's a very unconventional position. Never seen something like that. Yeah, I basically have to take, and now he's got the rook there. He has one possibility that he has is to play queen to d6 and possibly queen to b4. This is really a somewhat annoying idea. I think I probably should try to get rid of that rook quickly. Okay, he probably won't take, but this is still more comfortable in comparison than allowing queen d6 b4. On the other hand, this is not all roses for him. I could have taken e7, but that felt risky. Bishop b2, however, I just want to develop with knight f3 and castles. He wants to play knight e4. That's very understandable. I wonder if I should take on f6. Yeah, there's a question. Will I ever develop my kingside? Stay tuned. Yeah, there's a grain of truth to that. Okay, let's take that. Knight e4 is just awfully, awfully annoying, so I'm taking it. How is the video setup done? It's a question. You mean that that hologram style? Yeah, with a green screen, like they use it for TV and professional productions. I've got a big green screen behind me. So, what now? Yeah. If I take it, or taking with the A pawn? No, I don't believe in that. Let's take it. And now, yeah, I would like to get to the c7 pawn. That would be nice, but not easy. Let's just castle. Bishop e4, probably coming. Is there some way I can always go back to f1? Let's see. Any sharp openings today? I'm just playing what I usually play, which means like middle of the road stuff. I won't play anything completely bonkers. That was a bit too frustrating last week to be lost like after move 5 on the Latvian. So I'm just playing normal stuff. Yeah, this is kind of solid, I know. What now? Knight e5. I'd like to get in some kind of activity. Let's jump in knight e5. Oops, sorry. I'm not sure that he will take, but I can play that pre-move anyway. I can go bishop d3 maybe next. Is there some possibility to reach... Yeah, I think I'll try that. Knight to b4, knight to a6. Is he going bishop e7? Maybe. Yeah, he plays bishop e7. That is a good move. Yeah, definitely. I don't get there. Yeah. I don't get to that pawn on c7. Now he gets the bishop on c7. That's very helpful. From his perspective, I mean. So, yeah, I was thinking g4 might be an idea, but that's not really helping. So let's just drop back. I'm shuffling here, admittedly, not having any great ideas. Bishop d3, yeah, then the b5 pawn. b5 pawn will get weak. Can I go here and bishop d3? I'm really not sure about that. Very difficult to find any active idea. I don't really have an idea here in that position, I have to say. It is really passive. And 1 minute 20. Will I play some bullet games for my channel anytime soon? Not sure. It's not for everybody, yeah, to do commentary on bullet games. And I usually don't feel like doing that very much. Bishop g4 is a good move. Yeah, the weak h-pawn, but maybe I can do something. Now he's playing this, yeah. Yeah, he played that well. What can you do? He can probably just take on h2, play that position, and bishop e2 or something. It's tough to get any play here. He can play rook somewhere, yeah. That's a good one for starters. Not great. He probably can just push the b-pawn. I don't think that h5 is important. Yeah, that's also possible. Yeah, b3. b3 is just promoting. Rook c5. Okay, now he played that well. That wasn't a good position out of the opening. Wonder what was wrong there. But I really was in trouble right from the start. Around here. But that's already a bit uncomfortable. Even though black's position... Maybe I should really take that e7 pawn, I wonder. Okay, anyway, let's go for the next game. Let's go for a Sicilian. Yeah, I mean, okay, someone requested sharp openings. I'm going for a Sicilian, but I just don't play the dragon or stuff like that. It's not my way of playing. What is that? Queen d3? Really? That looks weird. Wow. Okay. I don't believe this one bit. So I can send him back there. Queen is on g3. Funny. but it take it makes it get it gets some pressure, yeah, on G7. Anyway, that should be okay in that position. Taking on D4, he's gone F4 here. Yeah, maybe rook c8. Yeah, it's not so easy to develop that bishop with the queen on g3. Interesting idea, queen d3. I don't believe it's any good, but ever going to bring back the bookcase background? Yeah, ask ICC. They requested the green screen setup. You want the books back? Just write to the ICC guys and request the books. It wasn't my choice. Let's see. Yeah, I still cannot develop that bishop, which makes me really nervous. I wonder if knight h5, knight takes f4 is an idea. Maybe I can do that. Is that working? Let's go for it. Yamo doesn't use the green screen, yeah, yet. He will. I'm basically piloting the green screen setup. Yep. Well, somewhere there's this resign button in the video. That's weird. Okay, I took on f4 for that e5 idea. I just wanted to get rid of that annoying pressure. Yeah, it's 10 p.m. Central European. Yeah, that is 10 p.m., right? So let's see, what about this? I still cannot develop. What about queen e7, queen to e5? Is that, yeah, I think I have to do something like that. It looks a bit awkward, but how do I ever get development? Maybe e5 now for him. It's an interesting move. Queen e5, rook e1 loses straight away and pawn takes. But okay, that position is probably still fairly solid, I hope. Someone requests me to make my own Twitch channel. I have a Twitch channel, it's just I don't use it. I don't have time for streaming, really. Bishop e7, knight c7, check. Oh, I can go king d7, which is not ideal, but... Or king f8, maybe king f8. So I can take a6, huh? So king d7, maybe? Really king d7? Back on that, it's not that bad here, I think. Maybe it's just my unwarranted optimism, but I'm not so sure if this position is so bad. No, it's not the Sicilian Khan, it's not really to my taste that much, because it allows hedgehog stuff, and I don't like to play the hedgehog. sorry, voice is failing me. Someone writes, Chess Explained is my hero. Yeah, that's nice, thanks. So let's see, I gained some time here. I'd like to take there and play Bishop f6, but it's not going to work. Maybe just here. It's a very strange position. Yeah, Greenwich time is not Central European time. It's a different thing. That's a question. What I do recommend to play against the hillbilly in the Karo Khan? Yeah, I happen to know what that is because Mr. Simon Williams made a video on that. It's just nonsense, that opening. Play whatever you want. Any normal move will suffice. Just d5 or whatever. It's just nonsense. Just don't take the pawns and you will be fine. I mean, nonsense is a bit strong. It's just not a very good opening. Black should have an easy game after it. Yeah, f6 is a bit ugly, I know, but how to cover that stuff there? Okay, he's coming over to g4. Okay, can I activate that bishop a little bit? g4. Bishop g4. King d8, ugly stuff. Ugly stuff. King d8 or king e8. here maybe. d6 looks kind of shaky. Yeah, going to c4. Still, I'm not seeing how I'm losing quickly. Maybe I should have played a3 here, yeah. Yeah, I will do that soon. No, now I won't do it probably. But knight takes c6 is not such a big deal. I can still play a3. Or take it and king c7. Isn't that fairly safe? Rook f5 is coming. Okay. Rook f5. I was planning to take h2. Okay, so here I can go queen c5. That should be okay, really. I don't see a big problem here. I could have taken e4 actually. Why didn't I do that? But anyway, maybe b4, or is that happening? I don't know. Queen b5. Take e4, what is the problem? You will take it, of course. Stupid stuff. Can go d5, maybe d5. Wow. I overlooked him. That's just he's a bit too much. He has too much on d5. What did I do here? Awful. Really awful. It was an okay position actually. Okay. What is he doing here? Don't get it. I don't get it really. I have 9 seconds, but rook takes d1 is a threat. Wow, what a what a swindle. I'm sorry. Wow, that was very lucky. Yeah, so let's next game. Someone remarked that Alex Yamolinsky made an ICC video about my favorite King's Indian line with h3 and bishop g5. Yeah, that's true. That line I had recommended a couple of years ago in a video series for white playing 1d4. Yamo at the time was a huge expert, so it's not like he copied from my idea or something. It's the other way around. Yeah, sure. Someone remarks that White could have won the last game. That's for sure. That was just a very cheap swindle. Okay, so we got an old Indian here against the Night Lord. The Night Lord. So let's go here. Someone requests me to play the King's Gambit. No, I will play normal stuff now. There's a question. When players talk about according to theory, white is better, what does that actually mean? Yeah, I'm not quite sure what is unclear to you about it. I mean, it means that white has somewhat better chances to gain something substantial. It's a substantial. Also, it might mean that it is easier to play. Yeah, that's also a very important thing. Like a position might be objectively totally okay, but it's sometimes easier for a particular side to find the right moves. Just a matter of practicality. Someone asked me, how do I imagine the chessboard in over the board games like 2D or 3D? Pooh, cannot tell you. I really don't know. Really don't know. How do I imagine that? Yeah, it's three-dimensional, I guess, but it's I really never thought about it. Okay, this position here is very nice, as c5 is a big weakness, and he has a hard time to cover that. I will just attack it and pick it up, I guess. Ah, the theory part. Okay, what does theory mean? Yeah, in that it just means that people have devoted some time to figure out what the best moves may be, and in that case, we call it theory simply because it has been checked and verified theoretically, meaning not in a game, but in study, yeah, on over the board with computers or whatever. Very often, you have to also make a difference between the theoretical evaluation of a position and the practical value. In some cases, it might happen that a position is actually very well valued theoretically, that one side is better, but the practical results speak a different language. For example, the King's Indian defense is a very typical case for that, where quite often white players do have an advantage theoretically speaking. Because you see that objectively chances should be higher for white, but in practical play, black very often succeeds because he has dangerous counterplay. Someone asks, why was it that yesterday in Blitz he beat people regularly on a particular day, and the next day he played worse? How does that happen? That's one of the totally unclear things in chess. Yeah, this weird animal called shape. Yeah, some days you're in good shape, some days you're in terrible shape, and frankly nobody knows why it is. Like some days are much better than others. If there would be a clear recipe, I think people would avoid the bad days, but it seems totally unclear. I've got I got those days myself. I remember very vividly that last year I was playing in the German singles blitz championships for the first time. I never tried to play those single blitz events over the board in Germany. But I tried and I got to the German championships, and I really felt that on a good day I can do things. I mean, not win the event, but I wouldn't be afraid of anybody. And I played like a complete no words, yeah. I blundered pieces and it was just absolutely awful. A little bit like most of my games looked like the black players' games in that particular game, yeah. Yeah, just getting outplayed, losing pieces and stuff like that. So you have days that are totally inexplicable, yeah. And on some days you are sharp. It has something to do for sure with how you slept the day before, the night before, and your nutrition. I think that's totally important. But I've also had good games and days where nothing really seemed to fit, and then I still played well. Yeah, there's a remark that John Fedorovich also had problems with the ICC simultaneous display software. Yeah, that's I cannot really say that's good to hear, because I would like Fed to have a good time when he plays the simul, but at least I'm not the only one who struggles with it. I hope that we can do something till next time to help. Something can be done to help me play the simul better. There's a common source where is there a common source where the theory is documented for all openings? The Encyclopedia of Chess Openings. Yeah, that's hopelessly outdated. And usually you say it's known to theory if it has been published somewhere or has been played in a game. Funny enough, it's also called theory if it has been seen in a game. Yeah, like in a practical game. So what happens here? That seems kind of wrong. It seems a bit wrong. Queen b3, is that a move? It's probably not. Maybe I'd start with capturing. And rook c1. It looks a bit loose. Black setup looks rather loose. We'll see. Another question. Can I please explain tactics you are using in mid-game as you play? I can try. But it's not all tactics. Many moves are just fit in the position. There's a question. What is my opinion on the Karokan book by Jovanka Huska from 2015? Yes, that's a good book. I also got it just very recently. And I couldn't yet look at it in a very detailed fashion. I want to do a review on the book, but I didn't manage yet. I simply don't want to do a review without having looked at the book in enough detail. So it will be on my channel, but not the other day. Yeah, I've been very busy in recent weeks, 2 or 3 weeks, let's say, with my own book. My own book is out, of course, as I said earlier, and I'm currently busy sending out signed copies to interested people. So I'm basically going to the post office almost every day and sending out books to people. That's a very nice experience, getting to know many people who are interested in my book, and it's some very nice communications that I got from that. So I'm very thankful for everybody who ordered this book. Ever try a keto diet to improve concentration? What is keto? Keto diet? Is that low carb? I'm not quite sure. This is kind of irritating nowadays with all those different nutritional concepts. I tend to confuse the things. In that Karokan book by Jovanka Huska, she plays with short castles. Yeah, that's better than long castles. Okay, in that game that I'm playing currently, we've got an interesting situation. Black has pushed his pawns there in front of his king, which I'm not quite sure is such a great idea. He's got a weird bishop on b7. And I'm trying to get some attack going now. That's the question. How do I get a signed copy of my book? You should write a mail to me or send me a message on the ICC. That's also an idea. just get in contact. I mean, if you Google me, you will find ways to contact me. And try one of the ways. Email is the simplest because I will check it very regularly. And my email address is also simple. It's my first and last name and then @gmail.com. I'm going Bishop D3 here, but I'm not sure about that really. He's got this doubling on the D file, on the F file, which can be dangerous. Even though he's playing without that bishop, it's still not so easy. Maybe Bishop F3. I don't know. For C6 and capturing. Okay. Someone just informed me that the keto diet is no carbs at all. No carbs? No carbs is difficult for me. Low I can do, and I try. No is difficult. Okay, he probably has 95. It's a weird situation. Okay, I have to go G4. Keep that F file closed. It's a weird situation. Black's position looks strange to me, but I don't have a clear way of exploiting it. Is G5 a move? And then H4? I think I can play that. If I get in H4, that's totally fine. Yeah, someone says, I don't trust these diets. To be honest, I also don't. If you just do it in a way to do it too harshly, it doesn't make any sense. But to avoid totally unnecessary carbohydrates, I think is a very useful thing, especially avoiding sugar. I'm trying that now, and I already lost quite some weight, but it's a long road. So it's a nice position. H5 will come. That's a very, very, very good position now. So yeah, so someone, I think, I got a copy of my book in Amazon, but there's not yet the date of expedition. Yeah, the thing is that there are not that many books on Amazon that they ordered or that you can order, it seems, and they are out of stock. They are out of stock pretty quickly. A little bit like Black here is out of ideas against those pawns. So let's get going with the new game. Someone asked me, is it possible to challenge you? I'm watching the stream. Yes, you can do that. That's the question. If you had a lot of success with poker, like making 120,000 euro a month, would you have quit chess? A month, yes, I guess I would. 120,000 euro a year? No, I don't think so. 120,000 euro a year. Yeah, that's nice. It's nice to have, but you know, if you earn like 60 or 70 or 120, it means that you don't have to worry much about money. For me, it's not a huge difference if you earn 120 or 60 or 70 or whatever, and just be okay. Yeah, someone wanted to challenge me, but it said unavailable. I understand. I have this variable set, and I have to unset it somehow, but I don't know how it is done here actually in that software. So that's a Ruy López, and they played the late bishop takes c6, the delayed bishop takes c6. That's a very solid line that white players play quite frequently. I wonder if that was right. I think I have to play. I have to start with the other move. Anyway, there's a question. Do I play on chess.com? If yes, under what nickname? That's easy. My nickname on chess.com is also Chess Explained, but I don't play there that often. Someone says, if I earned 130,000 euros a year, you could afford to play some chess for fun. Yes, well, when I was still working at the bank, I mean, 120,000 it wasn't, but it was fair enough. And yeah, anyway, I still didn't quit chess. I played and studied what I wanted to do. And now it's a bit different, but it's totally cool. So let's see, he's trying to do something on the dark squares. My dark squares are weak. Yeah, I think I should try to get rid of that. Someone asks me if I play more Computer 4 Impossible games on chess.com. Well, this is an ICC stream, yeah, you know. I'm not really, I mean, I played those once in a while, but it is not very interesting in the long run to play against the engine. And this is not dependent on chess.com or any other platform. Playing against an engine is never really fun, so I don't do it regularly anyway. Yeah, and talking about not much fun, this position is also not fun. Can I get rid of one rook? I mean, I don't really think that so much is happening here. Oh, but it's damn uncomfortable. Ah, bishop d8. He didn't see that. That's lucky. Okay. I mean, he will retreat rooks. One rook. Whoa, really? That's surprising. With one rook traded, it should be really harmless. There's someone asking if there are chess bars in the place where I live. No, I won't find many in general. Who's the best person you've ever faced on ICC? You mean the highest rated, the strongest player? Oh, I played a couple of very strong guys. I played Nakamura a couple of times, Caruana, Rajabov. I also played Carlsen when he was a little kid. But in recent times, Caruana and Nakamura. Yeah, greetings back to Osnabrück. This is not, I mean, it's far away from my place, but relatively speaking, not so far away. Yeah, my opponent is mostly shuffling. There's not much to do. I can offer him a draw there. Maybe he takes it. Yeah, he takes it. It's very boring. Okay, that was a bit unfortunate. Very boring position. My question, what's my opinion, or a question, what's my opinion about the knight off? Yeah, great opening. Yeah, one of the best that you can play. If you like the Sicilian, like a sharp fight, let's play the knight off. Why not? I can do that, actually. I'm on the road. It was a bit of a Freudian behavior here while talking about the knight off. I played it. So there's a question. What do I think of Niklas' video series on Chess24 about the Nimzo and Bogo Indian? Yeah, Niklas Huschenbeck, Grandmaster Huschenbeck, did a video series for that server. And yeah, it's okay. He chose a couple of lines that are actually that I also have in the book. Yeah. And it was quite funny to see. Here, allowed bishop takes e6. I see it now. Yeah, he can take on e6 now. Yes. Wow, is that lost already? What a stupid move. Pooh. Yeah, that's really not great. Knight f5, knight e5. Can I survive that? I don't think so. Not against good play. Wow. He's got knight d5 coming. Wow, what a bad position. So, okay, let's take there. And see, queen h5. Okay. It's just complete rubbish. What can you do? What do I think of, like, of players that always play the same opening? It's an approach. I mean, I think it's a good idea to know some openings quite well and play them in some games, or in most games, let's say, to really have something that you can rely upon, something that you really know, not just like have some vague knowledge. That makes sense. But never, never deviate from those openings. Simply makes you predictable, which is a problem on a higher level. And it also is not much fun. Yeah, if you play the same stuff really every game. Yeah, so my recommendation is usually, and this is also what I tell my students, and an approach that I like, learn a couple of good lines that you know afterwards, so you have something that you can trust, that you can depend upon, but branch out from that. So in some single games, play something else where you see, okay, let's say you know your opponent plays the same defense every time, then that's a good idea to maybe test him in that. There's a question, what do I think about Sam Collins' books? To be honest, I don't think I have one book of him, of his. I think maybe I saw a video or something that he made, but I'm not totally sure. Okay, so what are you doing now after this move? It's very crude, but it's checkmate on b2. Somehow, I think I saw something that Mr. Collins did, but I can't remember. So if I take a4, he takes e7. There's something else there. Knight d2 is probably rubbish. Yeah, I probably have to take. There's a question if I would do a commentary with Niklas Huschenbeet in the future. Yeah, maybe I will. As I said, maybe I will. But it's not very high on the list of things to do. That is not meant in an unfriendly way. It's just that when it comes to my channel, I want to start to produce some more, more instructional content. And this was falling a bit short in recent times. There's a question about the Caro Kann book. You can learn some lines from that book, but it's not the main thing. Study complete games of the Caro Kann, let's say. Learn the middle games, what the ideas are, what kind of plans are good and what kinds of plans are not good, and this will help you to improve as an overall player, not learning lines by heart. Okay, that's a sharp position, and I'm just just hope the best, yeah, not really caring much. One important point is my king has moved already. I cannot castle long. Would be nice sometimes. Any news about the Ruy Lopez? Did I find a new line? I'm dabbling around with various things, but currently I'm experimenting a bit with the Sicilian. My plan here was rook c8, bishop e5, then it's not possible. And if he takes rook d6, I have rook c3. Tactics. Not sure if they work, but look interesting. Oh, b3. Okay, I can take a2 here, right? Or not? Don't see why not. Okay, queen b3. I don't know. White seems to fall apart a little bit here. Isn't he? I guess my non-knight of knowledge at the end wasn't a huge problem. I mean, I had a lost position, but it worked out all right. So, what now? Yes. Many fine-looking moves. Queen f3, maybe. Or is there something that wins? Knight d3, rook d3 is not so great. Yeah, maybe this move. Do I know any books which shows the Marshall Gambit in the QGD, or at least something that shows some plans? What is the Marshall Gambit in the QGD? There's a Marshall variation, which is not very good. I'm not sure if you mean that. In the triangle. Yeah, there's a book by Ruslan Shcherbakov. That's the best book on that line. A very good book. Okay, I played this, but I'm not sure. Maybe he can. I can take that pawn on b7, huh? Ooh, yes. Ah, awful. Awful. Okay, let's go knight e7 again. maybe he's blundering the queen. It's a weird maneuver. I had to cover that rook, though. Let's see, maybe I can get the queens off them. Yep, I was able to do that. So, cover here. And go from this position. He's got 6 seconds left. That's useful. Okay. Yeah, that's not really enough to win, but the time. Someone asked me to pronounce the word Scheveningen, the Scheveningen. I am not really good at it. I cannot really do it like a Dutchman. Do you like the Taimanov more than the Kalashnikov? That's not the problem, really. I like the Kalashnikov variation, but there's a bishop b5, and after e6, 2e6, there's no bishop b5. Okay, when can we expect some big tournament coverage, and when do you plan playing a tournament yourself? Next big tournament coverage on my channel and on the ICC will be the Singfield Cup. And I'm not completely sure. It should be in a couple of days, actually, like maybe like 10 days or something. You can certainly look it up. It's not not far off. And me playing a tournament, I don't have a classical time control tournament planned in this year, but but I'm trying to play the World Rapid and Blitz in Berlin. Scheveningen. Yeah, if I would practice, I can probably do it in an okay way. What about the Göring Gambit? Is that good or bad? Would you play it? No, I wouldn't play that. And it's not that it is particularly bad, it's just very unpromising. And if Black knows his stuff, he will equalize very easily. So let me think about this. What is my opponent doing here? He's pushing pawns forward here. Okay, let's go h4. Do I think that Carlsen will win the Singfield Cup after the worst tournament at Norway Chess? He's got good chances, sure. He's the best player in the world, so why shouldn't he win that event? There's a question about the Scheveningen pronunciation. No, there's no real S in there. It's this I cannot do it. not well. Okay, knight g5. That's a funky move. Let's take it and see what I can do now. How to play here? Yeah, I guess e4 should be right. There's a question. How much materially would you say the queen is worth in an equal position? That's no question. I'm sorry. Because every position is different, and especially considering such a huge material imbalance, it's impossible to say. There's a question. What might Carlsen earn in a year? I think there was some kind of article about that. It's not bad. It's certainly quite above $1 million a year, but it certainly depends if there's a world championship match and so on. Yeah, that's a very strange position. Both king positions are somewhat wacky. There is an S sound, Scheveningen, maybe. Is there good money for the author in writing a chess book? Do I get paid by copies sold? It depends on the contract. I guess most contracts have some sort of flat fee that you earn regardless of how many copies are sold, and then you get an additional bonus if you get above a certain number. It's not a great way to to make a living, to really focus on writing chess books. But it was a good experience to write that book, I have to say. Okay, I don't know, Rook e1 is maybe a bit dicey. I played that very in a very relaxed fashion. Can I play knight g5 here or something? He's attacking that rook on f1. Nah. How weird is that? The question, if there's a good opening book with a good repertoire for white with knight f3. There's no real complete book. There are books that have parts of this kind of repertoire, but not a complete one. So I'm wondering. Still cannot really sacrifice stuff here. Bishop e3 is coming. Maybe. Yeah, I'm probably am in bad shape here, but it's very difficult to tell. Was there a lot of copies of my book sold? I don't know. I have no information, but what I heard is that the German retailers sold a fair amount, so at least clearly more than of some other books that are comparable. So I'm okay with that. Any good book that you know of in the Catalan? There are a couple of Catalan books. There's one by Victor Bologan. There's also the recent book by... Whoa, what the heck? I cannot take f5. Yes, that's g5 because of queen takes d4. Still, I don't believe in that move here. What is that? What is the actual threat? He still put something on e3 or what? I have no idea. Let's play a move. I even don't know how many copies of my book were... printed. There's a question. Can someone buy a car in writing a single chess book? Sure, there are cars that are pretty cheap, but we're not talking about something great there. No Porsches, no Maseratis, stuff like that. And I mean, even my car is out of the picture. The second Catalan books would be Boris Avruk, the Israeli theoretician. He now lives in the United States. He changed location. So, B6. I don't know. That looks a bit flashy, but can I play some crazy house games next Monday? Maybe. It's funnier. Yeah, but I win two pieces here, yeah, and I will win on time. That one. And the rook, wow. Yep, I won that one. Yeah, I think I'm faring better now with my my normal openings. Okay, let's go for one more game. We are closer to the end of the stream. There are many, many questions, so I probably missed a couple, but I try my best. Everyone should do a Catalan book. Yeah, they haven't done one recently, maybe. I'm not quite sure. The question, do I watch chess videos for study? Yes, I do. Yes, I do. For example, I will definitely watch what Yarmo has to say about the h3 bishop g5 line. Yes, I have to take in the King's Indian, I mean. I will definitely watch that. You can buy some old Toyota Corolla that will be better than many newer cars and not that expensive. Probably. Toyota Corolla has the reputation of being very reliable, but it's probably not the car that I would like to drive much. Like to have at least some horsepower. Some fun while driving is certainly not a bad idea in my book. There's someone asking whether I'll be playing this chess.com streamers challenge. Yes, I will. It looks like it, that I can manage that date and time. The question, I don't like reliable cars. Yeah, I do, but I still like to have some fun while I drive them, otherwise I wouldn't. So let's see. Yeah, I'm playing this very in a very relaxed fashion here, not paying much attention. So Yeah, here we go. G4, yeah. I'm trying to do something on the long diagonal. And h3 is the next move if he's not doing something here. And I don't know what he should do. It looks pretty awful, actually. Ah, yeah, he's got c6 coming. I wonder... I can just take f3. Let's do that. There are a couple of funky ideas. Pawn takes, rook g8, check, king on the side, and then knight e4 is shocking. Now, yeah, a Lamborghini. No, I wouldn't even want one, because you simply cannot sit in those cars. It's just far too far. It's too damn near the road. It's totally uncomfortable. I never drove one, but just looking at it gives me some pain. Queen g5 and white resigns. How do you cover g2 mate? How do you cover that checkmate, buddy, Mr. Frederico from Brazil? That reminds me a bit of a certain soccer game last year. Yeah, that would be like Germany 5, Brazil 0, that position. So he resigned. Yeah, one more game. That was a short one, right? Let's go one more. And I have a good run there. GSVC. Well, that's a sick rating there. Who is that? Guillermo Sebastian Vasquez Coleman. Okay. Paraguay, or what? I always think that this is some Slavic flag, but it's Paraguay. Yeah, someone is talking about Lamborghini Gallardo. Fun. Yeah, someone wants the trophy wife that comes with the expensive car and not the car. Okay. okay, I'm just let's just think for a moment here. I think bishop f4 is good. Am I a fan of classical music? I like it, but I'm no expert. I really am no expert. So I have the autumn concert and opera tunes in my iTunes library, but I really have no particular idea. I'm kind of an interested amateur. And I really, what is this? I can win that pawn, right? There is no big point there, right? Or does he have something great here? Knight b4, or I don't really get that. So bishop g2, rook g1 looks like suicidal. Wow, what? You must be kidding me. I don't believe this one bit. Bishop f4, or I think he's got h6. Huh. Or bishop e5, maybe. Bishop e5, knight c6. Or just f4. He can take e3 then. It is, in fact, it is a bit complicated still. Okay, let's start with this move. It's not so easy to decide. It just looks like utter rubbish. Like every move should win, but that's probably not the case. Can you focus on winning this game? I don't know if I can. I can try. So I would like to get in bishop e5. That would be most promising. Okay, I'm getting out of this. Bishop f5, there's e4. So I don't mind this that much. Bishop takes, I still have e4. Oh, what is he doing? Ah, yeah, okay. So I have to go here and hope I'm not getting checkmated. Interesting. Queen e5 is in there, but yeah, queen e5 to trade queens. He will get lots of material back. I wonder if he really threatens something here or not. If I go queen g2, he takes f4. So he will probably win a pawn or so in the process here. Okay, let's come with that for the moment. Maybe I'm overlooking something. It's easily possible. Such a weird position. I'm not on the g-file anymore. I have to take that into account. Yeah, rook takes d7. He had queen takes f4 check. I saw that move, but he could take f4 with check. He has a couple of flashy moves. That one, okay, for bishop e3. And 94 as well. It's can check. He has got queen to d6 check, which I overlooked. Awful. Queen to d6 check. Yeah, I didn't see that he has the check on d6. After which I really have no particularly good move, or any move for that matter. I have only have this one. Which will be losing in the long run. Yeah, that's a shame. That was a completely, awful position for Black in the beginning, but he played well after that. The people with that rating, they usually can do something, right? I mean, they sometimes play utter rubbish, but then they at one point sort of recognize that and then start to play well. Bishop takes there. I can try a little bit here. What is this actually? It's a rook against two pieces. So he still has some chance. He can still screw it up somehow. The same is of course true for me here. I can easily blunder more stuff. But that rook, well, that's not so clear, this position. Why am I so negative here? The rook on the 7th is very much a problem for him. So I cannot go rook e1, but I can take. Again, not rook e1, but I think I should try to use this. Ah, no, we can just take that. Okay, the position was still quite interesting because of the active rook. So I have to resign that one. But it was a good session. I won a couple of nice games, interesting games there. And we got many good, interesting questions. There's a question. Who do you think will win the Streamers Challenge? Not clear, as I think the field is probably still quite fluent. Chess Network never will play that. That's kind of clear. You never know who's going to win it. Eric Hansen is probably one of the favorites, but I think Maxim Dlugi is also going to play. He's also a very good blitz player. You never know. It's a matter of how you fare on that given day. I would be very surprised if I would win it, but I hope I can get in some cool games. Okay, so guys, thanks for watching. I hope you had a good time, and I'll be back next week, next Monday, for a new stream. Thanks for watching, guys.